that 007 reveal in the hand, even at the table read, just floored us.
My name is Miranda Bailey.
Dr. Bailey.
Dr. Bailey.
Dr. Bailey.
Miranda, there you are.
Bailey, what would I do with that?
I hope you never have to find out.
Yeah, it's the familiarity of having somebody like this, in, you know, in your house. So you know that you've met them or you've seen them or they've been in your face. You remember that. And people usually ask, our kids went to the same school before they realize, oh no, it's on that TV show. That's what it is. I'll say that to the right person. I say, no, I don't watch television at all. I keep it to myself.
I'm Dr. Miranda Bailey, Chief of Surgery at Grace Sloan Memorial Hospital. And I approve this message.
It's okay. You go.
Scariest story to tell, right? The scariest story to read at the table read. Letting you know how life can change on a dime and knowing how much of our audience was going to respond to that, right? How it makes you want to turn back time, like right in the moment, and get a do-over. So mostly I remember collectively us all feeling like, what's our audience going to do with this, right? But then embracing the challenge of telling that story, because that is real. And that's the one thing that our audiences appreciate from us, is that they're going to get something genuine and they're going to get something honest, even if it hurts, even if it hurts really bad. Bless his heart. He was one of my biggest champions when I started directing. He said I was really good with being able to manage him. He was just always so incredibly encouraging. And, you know, another one of my babies, they all, the entire cast became my babies as a result of directing them. You know, just all my special babies. Wow, you know, she is a writer first, right? The ideas, they just live in her head, and she empowers her writers to think that same way, to have these ideas, to come up with these characters. So a lot of times we exist here more than we exist, you know, here. And I always hope to not be disappointing as the person as opposed to the one that's up there.
Dr. Bailey, I don't mean to bother you, but...
Then don't.
It's Mr. Jones.
Is he dying?
No.
Then stop talking to me.
Yeah, she did say that there was a lot of the personality of her mother that was there, even though she was written as a short, white, blonde female named the Nazi. But I related to that in that when I saw Bailey's words on the page, I was thinking about my mom.
Yeah.
And I was also thinking about a teacher mentality.
Yeah.
Which at any given time you cannot like, right? That might resonate, yeah.
You want to try to write again? Can you hold the pen?
That 007 reveal in the hand, even at the table read, just floored us. What an amazing way to do that. And again, completely unexpected in the story of that episode. I don't think anybody was sitting back foreseeing that that's who that was on the operating table. And for Bailey in particular, that was one of her early babies, right? One of the ones that she claimed. And that just broke her heart. It just broke her heart. The audience got a chance to feel that, right, vicariously through her. They got a chance to have their heart broken. And so he was one of our earliest losses. And I think that's what makes him the most painful. not only was it important to be able to introduce it, but important to continue it, right? Because sometimes we just want to show something and put it in a bottle and put it away. But no, this is a daily life journey with Miranda Bailey. So as much as possible, whenever we can, we show her living with her mental health and having to check in, and what happens when you don't check in, and you know, the importance of self-care. Right, because the question is always, can I have it all? Can I do it all? Is it going to be 100%? And no, it's not. But guess what? That's okay. And Miranda Bailey is somebody that we have watched as a resident have a goal of being chief of surgery one day. And over the seasons, we've watched her be able to attain that goal, to lose a marriage, get a new marriage, raise a son, watch her, all of her babies blossom and become who they're going to be. And the fact that she's still there, she's one of those solid hosts, I guess, that's there for the audience to be able to see everybody else through.